Hi everybody, it's Faye. I'm going to be doing a Talking to Heaven cards, a little kind of mediumistic message giving. Again, it might not apply to everybody, so unless you're really looking for a message from Spirit, then this isn't maybe the pick a card for you, but a lot of people seem to like it. Before I start, it's just a lot of people have been wondering about how private readings work. Because everybody's in a different time zone, I have to just do it as a video, okay? So if you want a private reading, email me with a question. I don't do ones about medical stuff, guys, because that is just a different realm. You really have to see a private doctor for that. And things to do with investment of money, I don't like to do that either. I can look at your job situation, your love life, general things about your life, that kind of idea, what is going to be coming up for you. But please don't ask me to predict anything about pregnancy or anything like that. I'd rather not. Anyway, let's get started. Oh, and thanks to everybody who's already booked readings with me, and I just thank everybody who's donated to my channel. It's been very, very kind of everybody who has done this. Thank you very much. Right, let's get started. Those who are new to doing pick a card, I would ask you to pause your video, pause your screen, and see where you're drawn to. 1, 2, 3, or 4. If you're drawn to more than one, that's fine. This is also, you can come to this at any time. It's not about in June of 2018. Whenever you feel drawn to pick a cards, I feel my particular readings are for whenever you are drawn. Okay, so let's get started. So pause your video and then we'll get started. I'm assuming you've paused your video, so now we'll get started. Those who chose number one, and by the way guys, I've been writing down notes all morning. I felt as if I was drawn to do this today. I don't know why. So I've been writing down notes. If you hear me shuffling, it's because I have written down notes that I maybe feel as pertinent to whatever comes up. I am here helping you. The earth is our school. Now, these two cards, I really feel that the person who's been drawn to number one, the message here is this person is trying to tell you that, see all the heartache, everything that you're going through the now, where it might seem almost like, do you know what, I don't understand why this is happening to me. It's like one thing after another, you know, it's just like everything seems to be becoming overloaded. It's almost like you've been tested. And I think that this could be somebody that's close to you that's passed, your spirit guide, your higher self, whatever you feel is guiding you. And this is what they're trying to tell you, that beware of feeling that you're being put upon, because you're not. It's almost like you're being tested to see past your ego. To see past your ego and see what is really important. Because I think a lot of the times when we're here and we're physical plane here as a physical entity, we get into our ego a lot, and we're actually made to look at competing all the time. We're competing all the time for, you know, the next material thing or whatever. And really, I feel what's happening with you is you're going to start getting more kind of messages of enlightenment, if that's the way to put it, is that is not what is important. This spirit that's moved over now realises this, and that's what they're trying to pass on to you, that the most important things are the things that money can't buy. No amount of struggled for financial gain can really give you total fulfillment. The things that are important is love, your family, your friendships, basically the things that you can't buy. This is something that you've got to give from your heart. It's becoming more heart-centered, and this is what I think the message for number one, that's what I felt with the message off of these cards. This spirit knows this now. They've maybe been a person in that when they were here in this forum, they worked all the time to maybe give their family everything that they thought they needed to have, and you know, more material rather than their time. This is what I feel that the message is, and they're going to tell you no. They wish that if they were still here, they didn't do that. That the most important thing is the love, and that love is still here with you for the person who picked this, and they're definitely with you all the time. I'm also feeling that everybody who's listening to this, you've maybe had wee little experiences. Okay, you're maybe smelling a scent that's becoming familiar, or hearing a song, or something like that. They're telling you it's true. It is what you think it is what it actually is. I think they're asking you also balance. You're needing to balance your life between work and work and family life. You're having to balance that. People who picked number two. I wish I had told you more often how much I love you. My mind is free. I think this person was quite non-demonstrative. They weren't a person who was openly openly affectionate, but they'd maybe show their affection in different ways. You know, they maybe do a very kind wee thing that you would think, oh, all right, maybe take you back. But this person is telling you that they appreciated you, whatever it is that you did for them, whether it be while they were still here in the earth plane, all the wee things, maybe doing their shopping, or just making sure they were okay, looking in on them, or just being a friend to them was actually meant a lot. They really did appreciate you. That didn't go unnoticed, and they're now wishing that they could have been more demonstrative. It could have just been the way they were brought up, and it normally is. You normally find people who are quite, they don't know how to be affectionate in a kind of touchy-feely, kissy, cuddly way, is because they haven't had it themselves. Now that they've passed over, they realise that, do you know what, it's an expression of love, and they wish that they had done that while they were here, but they are still there, and you know, it's almost like they're blown kisses to you. Also, I think as well, this person, they may have passed to the next realm, if you like, through something to do with a head injury or Alzheimer's, dementia, something to do with the head, okay? But they are now, this message can also be that they are free of all worry, because I feel this person is quite a worrier. And I think they're passing the message on to you, please don't worry, because worry and fear-based energy is what keeps you down. It stops you from vibrating at higher energy. So this message from this spirit, or this higher soul, higher energy, whatever it is you perceive it to be, is telling you to stop worrying, because the energy, remember, we're all energy. I'm going to give you, for instance, in case you don't understand what I mean. Say you keep thinking of somebody for some reason, and all of a sudden they phone you, or you think of somebody and you meet them in the street. That is your energy. You're putting that out, or they're putting that out. So the two are connecting. So be careful of your thoughts. See if you start to have any kind of negative thought pattern. Stop it in mid-track. Because what you're putting out, especially if you're doing it in a constant loop, you're bringing it to yourself. And this spirit knows what you are thinking. This spirit is telling you that they are asking you to please be aware of your what it is that you're giving out, your energy, because fear is just an illusion, okay? You need to try and come away from that. I know it's very difficult in the world that we live in, because we're bombarded with things that horrify us, but please turn your TV off, just don't listen to the news, because it's just fear-based all the time, and this is what the spirit's asking you to do. Please free your mind, because they've had to pass over to the other side to do that. They also love you very, very much. the message here is they love you. They just wish they'd been more demonstrative when they were here. Those that pick number three, there is no such thing as death. I am so much better now. I think like that, this person did suffer quite a bit, could have been maybe ailing for quite a long time, maybe quite bedridden for quite a long time, and they just feel fantastic. They've got rid of this heavy duty body. Okay, remember guys, this is just your vehicle that you're in. This isn't you. I know it's not you, you know what I mean? Your body is not what you are. And they're telling you that they feel absolutely amazing now. They've got rid of the heavy, cumbersome body that kept them bedridden and ill. I actually feel this person struggled to even maybe walk. But they want you to know that you've not to stop worrying about them, because they are now back to prime health. And they're asking you to maybe look at how your vibration is, because I also feel as well that you have been worrying about how they passed and if they were in pain and if they knew what was going on, and know that they weren't in pain. They weren't, because something happens within the soul and your consciousness that would just trigger that off. You become cut off from the pain. Your body and your brain is such a magical vehicle that you've got, that no, that this person wasn't in pain. And they're also I think you've actually been questioning. You've been questioning about why are you here, or what is this all about? And that this spirit or this higher being is letting you know there's no such thing as death. All you're doing is changing your vibration, and that veil is becoming thinner and thinner and thinner. See, and again, I think I've said this for somebody else, I also feel the people who's got this, there's no such thing as death. Don't think of your loved one. They're telling me to let you know that don't think of your loved one as being up there, okay? Up there, away, some, they're not, they're here. They're here. They're just on a different vibration to you. That's why you're maybe getting little, I don't know, signs, if you like, signs. You're maybe finding little coins. A lot of people look at feathers or a little birds, admirals, something like that. There'll be something you'll think, oh God, that just makes me feel of whoever it is you're thinking of. And that's because it is them. Don't doubt it. In 2018, since the beginning of the millennium, and then in 2012, there was supposed to be this big change. Well, there was. We didn't all see it, but there was a huge change, and everything's speeding up now. You'll find that your own vibration is speeding up. Who's found that time has no relevance anymore? You feel as if you get out of your bed, you start doing whatever, and next minute it's lunchtime, you start doing that, next minute it's tea time has no relevance any longer. We are speeding up in our vibration, and this is what this card is telling you. There's no such thing as death. Your loved one, whoever it is that you're thinking of, whether it's a loved one, a family member, and a husband, wife, whatever it is, even your pet, by the way, they are still here. They're still here. And don't think for one minute, if you feel, you know, a lot of people are actually starting to feel being touched as well, feeling a strange touching feeling. I've been feeling a lot on my hip. I know it sounds bizarre. A lot on my hip. And I think personally, when I stand at my worktop when I'm doing it and I feel it, I had a cat that lived, he was 19, 20, and he used to stand up and hold on to the tabletop and pop my leg. Sorry, I'm seeming to be off the bait drag here, but just to let you understand, I now think that's what I think that's him. I really do believe that this cat is still around me, and because the veil is becoming thinner and thinner, we are starting to get physical manifestations. So those that pick number three, I think you're going to have some kind of message, whether it be in a dream, something that you see on, you know, see on in a magazine or whatever, something is going to happen that you are going to be having a kind of wow moment. Okay, that's for number three. Those that picked number four, I'm sorry about that, guys. Someone's out there with, I don't know what it is. It sounds like a dirt bike or something. I'm going to close the door. Give me a sec. My back door's open. It's such a beautiful day. That's a bit better. That's better. I can still hear it, but it's not quite as bad. I am not dead. I am just a thought away. Again, you know, there's no such thing as death. I am not dead. And I think like that, the person's pick number four, again, is that you have been thinking of this person and you keep giving this thought out. And every time you think of them, they're right beside you. They're going to be right beside you. They've been on your mind for quite some time. I don't know if this person's not long past, or maybe been, you know, if it's a case of not long past, you're kind of still in that mourning, that grieving period. Give yourself a chance to grieve, but please know that the person that you keep thinking about is beside you. They are there, they're still there. I feel as if all these messages are very, I just feel that this whole day, this whole reading is about people starting to have more connection to the spirit world, and they don't understand it. I think that's what it is. There's no such thing as death as you think it is. I believe if you've came to this reading, you know that, okay? You're not going to be somebody who's an atheist or doesn't believe in the afterlife coming to this reading, because why would you? Why would you? But you're still not really that sure. You're not quite sure what this means, I am not dead. It's because we think of ourselves as what we see in the mirror, okay? What we see, what we feel. And that isn't who you are. That is not what you are. Anybody who's had an out-of-body experience, me being one of them, knows this. Okay? When you have an out-of-body experience, you know what this is trying to tell you, what this spirit's trying to tell you. You can look back and see yourself lying there. So your physical being is not who you are. Your higher consciousness. And this spirit is letting you know that every single time you put out a thought to them, it's because they're around you. You think it's just you that's thinking about them, but their presence, their energy is actually having an effect on your being. I'm also feeling, and I'm hearing as well, that things are maybe going to start getting moved about in your home, okay? Maybe your keys are going to go missing, or things are just going to start, be silly things that might drive you a bit crazy. But it's this spirit that's letting you know that they're there. It could be something as silly as taking your bookmarker out your book and changing the page. They have been known to do. Carrying on and winding you up. That's what this, people at pick number four, you are going to start to get that kind of interaction. I feel that they've maybe been, you know, tapping away and doing things, maybe making wee noises and things that you can't, you've been all over the house to try and find where these wee noises are coming from, or your car or something, but it's whoever it is that you've been thinking about. And it's not just you that's thinking about them, they're planting their energy into you. Right, guys, I hope you liked that wee reading. I'd like to do more on spirit communication. You can let me know if you want to hear or know anything about any of my experiences, because they go back like over 20 years. But I don't want to frighten or scare anybody, or, you know, come across as being a bit kooky. Well, actually, I don't really care if I come across a bit kooky, as you've probably gathered. So I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope you get something out of it. Just know that whatever card you went for, your loved ones are just doing great. Okay, don't worry about them. They're there to let you know not to worry about them. They're the ones that will probably be worrying about you. If you have not already subscribed, please do give us a thumbs up. If you want a personal private reading, tarot card reading, you can get me, you can email me at faystrachan1@gmail.com. And what I would do then is get back to you. You can ask me a question or how what it is you want your tarot card reading to be about. Whether it's just a general what's happening for you for the next year or so. And what I would do is you can pay me through PayPal. It's British pounds, so I don't know what it would be for whoever you are. You can always get one of these converter things. Converter machine. So it's £35. Pay into PayPal, and I would do a video and send it to you. And it means you've got it on this. I do videos because people are all over the world now. I kind of do Skype at 3 in the morning and that kind of idea. It just lets everybody get a video of when I am at my peak, okay, at a certain time of the day. So please get in touch and let me know if you would be interested in getting a private reading. Again, guys, speak to you all later. Bye-bye.